This is Terkel Sorensen with Century 21 Award and the Home Show. Today, I'm going to talk a little bit about the other investment option. The first one, as you remember, basically means that we buy the house, put a renter in here, take the extra money and put it towards the mortgage. Pay off your principal faster, pay off your mortgage in about 15 years. Let me just give you the numbers. This house built in 2004, so pretty close to brand new as far as houses go. Listed for $212,500, so not a bad price. 2,500 square feet, 4 bedrooms, 2-car garage, a good size house, something you can use. Let's say you put 30% down, roughly your down payment is about $65,000. Your payment on the $150,000 that are left, probably what, $1,400, maybe a little less, maybe a little more, depending on the situation, taxes, all that kind of stuff. With that payment, if you're taking $1,600 to $1,700 in rent, you're doing okay. You can pocket this money or you can pay down your mortgage. Now, if you take the second investment strategy, which is to follow the market a little bit, every 10 to 12 years, the market does a hiccup. We call it an adjustment. And am I making this up? No. Okay. Last time we had foreclosures, 1995. And before that, early 80s. About 12 years apart, 2007, 12 years again, okay? So another 12 years, we're now in 2009, we've had a couple years here. Give it another 8 years, and we're gonna be on top, and then 2 years after that, we're gonna be down on the bottom again. So, buy the property, keep your renters in here, have them paid off for you, at whatever rate you feel like, you can pocket the 200 bucks, that's fine. You need a lot of these to actually make some money off of that, but of course, once it's paid off, well, you're pocketing more, so that's good. However, in 8 years, the value of this could just maybe double, maybe a little bit more. Let's call it $500,000 in 8 years. That should work out, okay? So $500,000 in 8 years, you sell the property. And you sell everything else you have. This is the strategy. You even sell the house you live in and go rent one, okay? Put the money in the bank. Don't invest it, just put it in the bank and hold it for 2 years while the market drops out on everybody else, okay? Now, once the market is dropped, who's sitting around with cash to buy property? You are, that's right. So now you go back into the market with the $500,000 that we have left over, and you basically go in there and say, okay, well, I'll take that one and that one. Get two properties for the price of one. That's what the price situation is today. You're basically getting a property for half what it's worth, or what it was worth a few years ago. So if you can accumulate a few of these, let's just call it 10, set up $5 million, you can double that into 20. And if you're really clever and talk to the right people, wink, wink, hint, hint, over here, with that kind of money, we can take you from buying one or two properties and put you into what's called bulk purchases. Bulk? Hey, what does bulk usually do for you? Oh, it gets the price down, right? So instead of paying $200,000 for the property, now you can get them for maybe 50, 60, 70 cents on the dollar. Okay, let's just call it crazy and say it's 70 cents on the dollar, $200,000 house, minus 30%. That's $60,000 off. It's now $140,000. By one, by two, by three, by... Hey, instead of two, you're almost buying four houses that will do the same thing with value. Go back up, you can rent them out, keep on rolling. Or you can take the house, flip it, put it back on the market at full market value, and sell it. Ooh, did I just hit a sore nerve there? You could actually turn the house around and sell it in 30 days and make 30% of value, minus my commission and goodwill and all that good stuff. Anyways, you get the picture. Here's some money to be made. You just have to get in there, okay? So that was investment strategy number two. And then next time, I think we'll talk about number three, which would be the bulk purchases. Now that requires something very special. Big money, a couple million dollars. If that's your game, we have different numbers for you, okay? And following that, we're gonna talk a little bit about how to finance these things. How much money do you need? How much cash will you have to hold in order to do this? get ready to get in the game because the market has turned and we are going up. You need to do this now. That's it for the home show. I'll see you next time. Have a great day.